afternoon, everyone. This is Kevin Gianni from the Renegade Health Show, and we are in Dallas, and we're actually in our buddy's apartment here, and he's more than just our buddy. He's actually a, well, pretty well-known fitness expert, and so what we wanted to do is we wanted to kind of give you some insight into how Anne Marie is getting some of her, well, Anne Marie, what would you say? Your buffness? Is that an appropriate look at that? You see that?
Oh my God. Those are better guns than Kevin.
You guys have been asking me how I get my arms.
There we go.
It's really just with some couple bodyweight exercises.
Yeah, and so we're here with Scott Colby.
Hey, everybody. How's it going?
Hey, and I don't know if you guys seen Scott Colby before. Scott, why don't you give him maybe a couple websites that you have?
Let's see. I've got a blog. You can get a bunch of videos at theabsexpert.com.
Cool.
If you want to go straight to the blog, it's theabsexpert.com/blog.
Cool. Great. And so you're here in Dallas, and you are going to show us some bodyweight exercises that you do with your boot camp classes to get them in tip-top shape. I mean, they're a bunch of women, right? You only teach women?
Yeah, it's women's only. And we do bring some equipment out on occasion, but we do a lot of bodyweight movements, which is conducive when you're training a large group. You don't want to have to bring a lot of stuff out there. So
great.
I just want to maybe show you some bodyweight movements. We'll put Anne Marie through the workout here.
All right.
Maybe you know, ones that your audience hasn't seen.
Cool. Great. So, let's do it.
Yeah. You want to try that extreme squat thrust? Extreme squat thrust. So, yeah, people know what a squat thrust is probably.
Yeah.
Want me to do one with you, Anne Marie?
If you want to.
Do the first one with you, then you got to do six more.
There's gonna be beginner and advanced for you guys who are listening right now, so or watching right now. So I just want to make you know, let you know.
Yeah, it's not that extreme. So we're gonna go down into a crouch, kick your legs out, go into one push up, kick them in, stand up, and then go into one jump and lunge. Now of course you can modify it by putting your knees on the ground for the push up.
Okay.
Okay. So maybe Emory could do a modified one. So go down into a squat thrust, put your knees on the ground for the push-up.
There you go.
Then come up and just go into a regular lunge, not a jumping lunge. So that's a good modification if you're new to that movement.
Great.
Really, it's a full body movement. Get your heart rate up, upper body with a push-up, lower body with the lunges, and it's really good conditioning movements. A full pull-up is pretty hard to do. So what Emory's doing is a modified pull-up or body weight row. Her legs are straight, so that's going to make it pretty hard, but her abs are going to get involved as well. But this is great for your back, and you can see how her arms got so buff.
Oh, yeah, look at that.
Perfect.
And now, if you don't have a machine like this, what can you use?
I started doing this type of movement on a playground, actually. And so there's contraptions you can buy, like gymnastics rings, but even if you don't have that, just find a long towel or a sheet
yeah.
and hang it over maybe a swing set or the jungle gym or whatever you can hang it over. So now you got the ends of the towel here, and then you can position yourself. So Anne Marie was actually fairly parallel to the ground. The more upright you are, so if we made this bar higher and she was more upright, it would be an easier movement. If we made this real low and she was completely parallel to the ground, it would be a lot harder.
Great.
But that'll help you get to eventually strong enough to you do your first pull-up.
Great. All right. That's a big accomplishment.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Pull-ups are really hard to do.
So we'll try another one that has a scary name, but it's not that scary. So sorry, I didn't make up these names, but the suicide plane.
Who made up these names?
I don't know.
Who is that person?
I think Kevin Gianni.
No way.
I just called him the walking plane.
Okay. So here you're starting in a push-up position. You're just going down on your forearms. And then back up. Great for your core stability and actually shoulder stability as well. This is a good movement. Even just doing 10 of these, you'll feel your abs pretty nice here.
Yeah.
So then we have that break dancer move. Anyway, not spinning on your head, not moonwalking. So Anyway,
not that good of a dancer.
Yeah, I'm not either. That for you?
I got a story to tell, but it's a little too long for this video.
And you're younger here.
Yeah.
If you get enough wheatgrass in me, I'm like...
Scott's a closet wheatgrass drinker here. It's good.
Okay. So what was this one again?
So this one actually, so you break, I brought my left foot towards, or my right foot towards my left side.
Oh, yeah.
And then it was... So bring your right foot over. So just do that, and then.
Nice.
Yeah, there you go. That's it.
Nice. This is great.
Yeah, so this takes some coordination as well.
You just,
but this is
can't think about it.
You gotta do it. And you just, you know, the other boot camp members are doing it, and they're just all having fun.
Yeah.
And we talk about we do a few animal movements.
That's nice. That's your own place.
Yeah. Bear crawl. Are you all familiar with that?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Animal movements are some of the best conditioning movements you could do. So, you know, bear crawl like that. Anywhere you want to demo that one?
There you go.
Yeah, that's perfect. You can make it harder by going backwards.
Oh. Ooh, we've never done it backwards before.
Yeah. You can go side to side, diagonal.
Okay.
And here's one we just tried in that boot camp recently. We went three steps on a bear crawl, flipped over three steps on a crab crawl, flipped over three steps on a bear crawl.
Oh, wow.
We just kept changing it up.
Okay.
So that's another good movement.
One thing I want to talk about is what you do. I think it's actually, you provide a really cool community or service to the community through boot camps. A lot of people say, well, what the heck's a boot camp? Why don't you explain what a boot camp is and maybe give some idea as to how someone can find one in their area? If you're in Dallas, obviously you can come to you, but you know, what can someone do and what's it all about?
Yeah, a boot camp, you know, probably stems from back in the day, military. Different branches had boot camps that people had to go through to get in shape for the military. And I think people extracted that into a workout. Now, there are different types of boot camps. Some are actually yelling and led by ex-military personnel, and some are not yelling, they're non-yelling, but still provide a good, intense group workout.
Right.
So that's kind of the way I do my boot camps. It's non-yelling, not threatening, but I like it because it builds camaraderie.
Yeah.
Mine are women only, and some people like that. There are co-ed boot camps, probably men's only. But so if you're looking for, let's say, a specific type of boot camp, like women's only, probably just want to search, you know, on the internet, actually, you know, Google, like if you, here in Dallas, if you Google Dallas boot camp, a lot of different boot camps come up.
Okay.
So definitely you want to, find one that you're comfortable with. It really, I find that you really get better results in a boot camp than actually even one-on-one training because, number one, it's more affordable,
mm-hmm.
so you can afford to go many times a week than maybe once or twice a week with a private trainer.
Mm-hmm.
And number two, the accountability of the other members. Some of the other members encourage you to keep coming to class. And we like to do like events every month. We'll get people together from camp and we'll go out to dinner and things like that.
Mm-hmm.
So I would just, you know, find one that you're comfortable with the instructor. Definitely, hopefully find one that lets you try out the camp first. Like right now we run it where you can try out our camp for 2 weeks for like $1. Or find a camp that provides a 30-day money-back guarantee.
Great, that's really helpful. I think, you know, I think maybe we should address very quickly, you know, how you know if you're being pushed too hard in a group setting like that?
Yeah, that's a great question, Kevin. You know, obviously in a boot camp, you got various fitness levels and age groups and things like that. So you want to find an instructor that'll tailor, even though it's a group workout, and usually just one workout is planned, there's different ways, like we modify that one exercise for Amory, the extreme squat thrust. We showed a less advanced version of that.
Yeah, great. Where can people find out more information about you?
About me? Well, my blog at theabsexpert.com.
Okay.
Is probably the best place.
And then locally, Dallas?
Locally in Dallas, my boot camps are at herstrengthdallas.com.
Cool. Great. Well, thanks for sharing.
Yeah, thanks for having me.
So, Amory, how do you feel after that workout?
I feel pumped.
Yeah. Well, great, guys. So, what's going to be the question of the day?
Oh, boy.
Have you ever been to a fitness boot camp? What was your experience? How about that?
That was a good one.
All right, go ahead and post that down below. This is Kevin Gianni and?
Amory.
And
Scott Colby.
Together we can change the health of the world, one show at a time.